ऑन इंडस्ट्रीज 2 लेक्चर नंबर 14 इज केमिस्ट्री ऑफ वाइटनिंग एजेंट्स। टेबल ऑफ कंटेंट्स, द टेबल ऑफ कंटेंट्स ऑफ दिस लेक्चर आर केमिस्ट्री ऑफ वाइटनिंग एजेंट, स्टिलबिन टाइप ओबीए, डिजायर्ड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ गुड ओबीए, केमिकल कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ ऑप्टिकल ब्राइटनर्स, वाइटनेस एंड ब्राइटनेस, लाइट एंड वॉशिंग फास्टनेस, फ्लोरिसेंस। सो इन दिस लेक्चर यू विल लर्न अबाउट द केमिस्ट्री ऑफ वाइटनिंग एजेंट। वट आर स्टिलबिन टाइप्स ऑप्टिकल ब्राइटनिंग एजेंट्स? And what are the desired properties of good optical brightening agents? The chemical constitution of optical brighteners, whiteness and brightness of whitening agents. What is the effect of optical brightening agents on light and washing fasteners? And what is the role of fluorescence on optical brightening agents? Chemistry of whitening agent. So what is the chemistry of whitening agent? Textile materials like cotton or polyester blends are almost always pre-brightened when manufactured. So the textile materials like cotton or polyester type materials are always pre-brightened in the process of their manufacturing. So these textile materials, for example cotton and polyester type materials, are blended with the optical brightening agents in the process of their manufacturing. This is because the printing and colors will be brighter and more attractive if applied to the bright fabric. So the optical brightening agents or the optical brighteners are applied on the textile materials like cotton or polyester type materials to make the fabric more attractive. So firstly, the fabrics are treated with the optical brightening agents, then they go towards the further processing like printing and further blending of the colors. So the optical brightening agents are added to make the fabrics more attractive and brighter. Moreover, the washing agents and commercial detergents available nowadays commonly have optical brightness combined in them, and while washing the fabric gets brighter. So the detergents we commonly use nowadays have optical brightening agents for the optical brightness. So the optical brightening agents and the optical brighteners are important components that are added in the detergents. So the brightening agents are added in the detergents to make the fabric whiter and brighter. When we wash the laundry with the detergents in which the optical brighteners are present, the fabric looks more whiter after washing the detergents in which the optical brighteners are present. It is known that in most cases, the presence of an optical brightener causes a decrease in light fastness of a dyed fabric or a dyed fiber. So the presence of optical brightener causes decrease in light fastness of a dyed fabric or the dyed fiber. Why? Because the optical brightening agents protect the fabric or the fibers of the cloth from the light effects. So they prevent the fabrics from the light effects. In this way, the dyed fabrics or the dyed fibers protected from the light fastness. These compounds can also have a direct photochemical effect on the fiber in the absence of dyes, as in case of wool. So the optical brightening agents have an effect of the photochemical effect on the fibers in the absence of dyes also. For example, in case of wool, so a photochemical reaction takes place. A photochemical reaction is a chemical reaction that is initiated by the absorption of energy in the form of light. So a photochemical reaction takes place by the absorption of energy in the form of light in the absence of dyes also. You can take an example of this, a wool. So a chemical reaction takes place that is caused by the absorption of ultraviolet light. Wavelength ranges from 100 to 400 nanometer and visible light 400 to 750 nanometer, or an infrared radiation of 750 to 2500 nanometer. Optically whitened wool is yellow on exposure to light much faster than the untreated wool by a photocatalytic process. So the wool is treated with the optically brightening agents or the optical brighteners. We can compare the wool which is treated with the optically brightening agents and the wool which is not treated with the optically brightening agents. On comparing the wool which is treated with the optically brightening agents to the wool which is not treated with the optically brightening agents, on comparing, we can come to the point that the wool which is treated with the optically brightening agents will turn yellow on exposure to the light much faster than the wool which is not treated with the optically brightening agents. And this happened due to the process of photocatalysis. So a photocatalytic activity takes place, and due to this, the whitened wool will turn yellow on exposure to the light. So a chemical reaction take place like a photocatalysis take place, and due to the photocatalytic process, the wool will turn yellow on exposure to the light. However, in color textiles, sometimes a difference on hue is detected already in the first domestic wash, even in case of solid colors. So when we wash the fabrics with the optically brightening agents, if they turn yellow in the first wash, their difference is neglected, and their difference is also neglected in the case of solid colors. So if the solid colored fabrics changes their color, their difference is neglected sometimes. This undesirable effect has been a considerable obstacle for several textile industries, with clients and consumers becoming more and more demanding. So the turning of fabrics towards a yellow color force an obstacle for several textile industries because the clients and consumers are more and more demanding about the colors. Therefore, it's important to study the effect in order to avoid as much as possible similar situations. So, it is important to study about the optically brightening agents and the optical brighteners in order to avoid the effect of the colors and the yellowish things that are present on the fabrics. In this slide, example of an optical brightener structure is shown. This is the structure of a Blancafort B. So, the Blancafort B was prepared commercially in order to study the effects of optically brightening agents or the optical brighteners on different fabrics. So, a study was carried out to determine the effect of the optically brightening agents or the optical brighteners on different fabrics. So the color fastness test and the washing fastness test was performed to examine the effect of optically brightening agents on different fabrics, like the solid fabrics, color fabrics, and the white fabrics. So finally, the adjustments were made in order to find the best color combination in order to reduce the difference between the initial and final situation. So a study was performed to improve the optically brightening agents or the optical brighteners. Stilbene type OBA. So what is the role of Stilbene type optical brightening agents? Stilbene is an important component in the making of the optically brightening agents. About 80% of the optically brightening agents are formed from the stilbene components. OBAs are not a substitute for bleaching. So the optically brightening agents are not used as a substitute for bleaching. They are used to obtain brilliant market whites. So the major role of the optically brightening agents is to whiten or brighten the fabrics. These white whites can be obtained without over bleaching and damaging the fiber. So the major advantage of the optically brightening agent is that they can white and bright the fabrics. Moreover, they do not harm the fabrics. They do not over bleach and damage the fibers. So, without over bleaching and damaging the fiber, they can perform their work efficiently. On cellulose, they have a poor wash fastness. But most commercially rounded detergents contain OBAs so that they are constantly replenished. The disadvantage of the optically brightening agent is that they do not work efficiently on cellulose because they have a poor wash fastness effect on the cellulose. But they work efficiently on the commercial laundry detergents. Some OBAs have poor wash fastness, while some non-ionic types have excellent light fastness. So some optically brightening agents do not work efficiently because they have poor wash fastness. while some OBAs work efficiently because they have excellent light fastness effect. So there are some non-ionic type optically brightening agents work efficiently due to their excellent light fastness effect. Fiber producers can include optically brightening agents in their spinning process. So the optically brightening agents are added in the fiber producers in this spinning process because these can have excellent durability to both light and washing. So the optically brightening agents are added in the fiber producers in the process of their spinning because they have an excellent durability and they have an excellent effect to both light and washing. You can also see the structure of steel beam in this slide. Desired properties of good OBA. So before selecting the good optical brightening agents, we must keep following properties in our mind. Before selecting an optical brightener for textile application, we must look the following properties. So before choosing an optical brightening agents for textile application, we must keep following points in our mind. Number one, it should have good solubility, should not have its own color, and good substantivity for the textile substrate under OBA application. So a good optical brightening agent have a good solubility, it should not have its own color, it possesses the good substantivity for the textile substrate following the optically brightening agents application. Number two, optical brightening agents OBAs should have good light as well as wet fastness properties. So a good optically brightening agents must have a good light as well as a wet fastness effect. Number three is rate of strike on the substrate. So it is important to note that the rate of strike is very important for a good OBA. Number four, buildup and exhaustion properties. So a good optically brightening agents should have a buildup and exhaustion properties. Number five, requirement of electrolytes and its sensitivity towards different exhaustion agents. So for an optically brightening agents, the requirement of electrolytes and its sensitivity towards different exhausting agents is very important. Number six, effect of temperature on the exhaustion and buildup properties. So the effect of temperature on the exhaustion and buildup properties are very important for the good optically brightening agents. So how the optically brightening agents affect on the temperature? It's very important to find out. Number seven, application on pH change and sensitivity towards change in pH. So a good optically brightening agents should be sensitive towards the change in pH, and how it works on the pH change is very important. So before selecting a good optically brightening agent, it must be keep in mind that it is sensitive towards the change in pH and how it works on the pH range. Number 8, effect of water hardness. So a good optically brightening agents work efficient on the water hardness. A good optically brightening agents work efficiently on the salt water as well as on the hard water. Number 9, it should have good leveling and penetrating properties. So a good optically brightening agents should have a good leveling and the penetrating properties. It penetrates on the fabrics very well. Number 10, should not decompose to colored products on exposure to atmospheric conditions as well as storage, and it should not absorb light in the visible region. So a good optically brightening agent does not decompose the colored products when they are exposed to the atmospheric conditions. When we store the optically brightening agents on exposure to the atmospheric conditions, they maintain their properties and they should not decompose to colored products. A good optically brightening agent should not absorb light in the visible region. Number 11, it should be compatible and stable with finishing chemicals, auxiliaries and processes such as heat and temperature. So a good optically brightening agent should be compatible and stable with the environmental conditions such as heat and temperature. Number 12, it should be stable and fast to common oxidative and reductive bleaching chemicals and bleaching systems. So a good optically brightening agent has a fast effect to the common oxidative and reductive bleaching chemicals and the bleaching systems. Chemical constitution of optical brighteners. So the optical brighteners are composed of the following components. Optical brighteners are usually derived of triazine, steel beams, ditetra or hexasulfonated, coumarins, imidazolines, diazole, triazoles, benzoxazolines, biphenyl steel beams. So in this slide, some structure of the optically brightening agents and the fluorescent brightening agents are shown. So mostly the optically brightening agents are derived from the steel beam components. They are also derived from the biphenyl and the 5-member heterocyclic compounds such as imidazoles. The 6-membered heterocyclics such as coumarins and triazine. So in this slide, some structures are shown that are the base structures from which the optically brightening agents and the fluorescent whitening agents are derived. Brighteners can be boosted by the addition of certain oleols like high molecular weight polyethylene glycol or polyvinyl alcohol. These additives increase the visible blue light emissions significantly. Brightness can also be quenched. So how the brightness can be boosted? We can boost the effect of brightness by using the certain additives. The brightening effects of the brightness can be boosted by the addition of the certain chemicals such as polyols, polyethylene glycol or polyvinyl alcohol. So these additives increase the visible blue light emission significantly. So there are some additives which are added in the optically brightening agents or the brighteners to boost their effect and to increase the visible blue light emission significantly. So it is possible that the brightness can also be quenched. Too much use of the brightness will often cause a greening effect as emissions start to show above the blue region in the visible spectrum. It is important to note that we should use the significant amount of the optically brightening agents. If we use the optically brightening agents too much in the amount, that will harm the fabrics, because too much use of the brighteners will cause a greening effect, because the emissions start to show above the blue region in the visible spectrum. Besides the formation of cis isomer in steel beam containing brighteners, only the trans isomer is optically active. Continued exposure to UV containing light will actually cleave the molecule and start the process of degradation. So there are some steel beam components are present in the optically brightening agents. And cis steel beam and the trans steel beam are found in the optically brightening agents. So in the steel beam components, the trans isomer is optically active. And the degradation will start if the steel beam containing brightness continued their exposure to the ultraviolet containing light. And this ultraviolet containing light cleave the molecule and will start the process of degradation. Whiteness and brightness. To the trained observer, even bleached or white textile materials has a slight yellow tinge. So those fabrics which are bleached are often appear yellow. So the fabrics or the textile materials are treated with the bleach and the whitening agents. So they often have a slight yellow tinge. This small amount of yellow can give the impression of slight soiling and may detract from the aesthetic appeal. The presence of slight amount of blue gives the impression that the textile material is whiter. How we can remove the yellowness from the textile materials? Or how we can make the whitening agents or the bleaching agents more useful? To make the whitening agents or the bleaching agents more efficient, we can add some blue dyes or pigments in the whitening or the bleaching agents. Because the small amount of yellow can give the impression of slight soiling and it can detract from the aesthetic appeal. So there are some sort of blue dyes or the blue pigments are added in the fabric and the textile materials, and these blue pigments or the blue dyes makes the fabrics whiter. Before advent of optically brightening agents OBAs, improved whiteness was obtained using a laundry blue, which is a blue pigment. So before optically brightening agents, a blue dye was used to make the fabrics whiter and brighter. The development of optically brightening agents, optically brighteners, had meant that the slight addition of blue can be obtained through the light reflected by the OBS in the presence of ultraviolet radiation. This makes white textiles whiter and brighter. So how we can make the fabrics or the textile materials whiter and brighter? We can make the textile materials whiter and brighter by the addition of blue dye or the blue pigment. So a slight addition of blue dye can be obtained through the light that is reflected from the optically brightening agents in the presence of the ultraviolet radiation. So when the light is reflected from the optically brightening agents in the presence of the UV radiation, this makes the fabric and the textile materials whiter and brighter. Colored textile materials tend to appear brighter. OBAs are present in most domestic, but they are usually only suitable for cellulosic textile materials. So, to appear the colored textile materials whiter, the optically brightening agents or the whitening agents are added. The optically brightening agents are used in the domestic purposes, but they are only suitable for the cellulosic textile materials. Assignments. Assignment number one is, what is the chemical constitution of optical brightening agents? Assignment number two is, how we can overcome the drawbacks of optical brightening agents?